1380Z. Conklin and Company with 1380Z Action News anchor Lee Conklin. First with what's happening behind the headlines. And Take 3, our panel of political analysts.
And good morning, everyone. Welcome into another edition of Conklin and Company. Today on the program, the movies come to Sylvania. A local film producer, perhaps better known around these parts as a financial advisor, joins us to talk about his movie, parts of which, once again, shot right here in Northwest Ohio. In Take 3 today, we're going to hit the national and political scene, but also go local. The mayor's attempt to raise the pay range of his top staffers, and it sounded good, perhaps too good to be true. Turned out it was the Southwick development deal that failed before it really got started. But first, getting you ready for the conventions. The GOP goes first in Tampa this week, and 1380Z has you covered. 1380Z's Washington Bureau Chief Jacqueline Policastro, who will be there. And Jacqueline joining us this morning in Washington just ahead of her trip south. Jacqueline, good to see you.
You too, Lee. How's it going?
Good. Let's talk about, first of all, I want to talk about Isaac, because that is the story making headlines, this weekend. Isaac turning its way through the Caribbean, slated to hit perhaps the Gulf Coast, South Florida. What are you hearing as you get ready to go south?
Hey, Isaac. Well, what I can tell you is that we're saying hello to Isaac, whether we like it or not, according to some meteorologists. I can tell you that our rain gear is definitely packed, although we have heard from Republican convention officials that they're keeping everything on track, and they're really not getting overly concerned, but they're just being precautious right now. There's really no way for us to know exactly what's going to happen, so we're just going to have to stand by and wait.
Yeah, we're taping here at the end of the week, so as storms are fickle, they could go either way. We'll see what happens as we work our way toward the beginning of the week and the convention itself. But have you ever covered a tropical storm? You're a political reporter. What about tropical storms and hurricanes?
I actually haven't covered a tropical storm, but I've been in my fair share of tornadoes. I worked in Indiana for a while, and I am from the East Coast originally. So, you know, I've been in a few hurricanes, just not necessarily working. But don't worry, I'm ready.
All right. Well, let's turn it now to politics. What can we expect from the GOP this week? This is so important for them. The polls are so tight right now. Mitt Romney needs a bump. So what can we expect?
Well, for Republicans, this is really an opportunity to solidify their base. They're going to be putting Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan out there and officially nominating them as the head of the Republican Party. And these conventions, they really do have sort of a party-like atmosphere. But let's not forget that there's also this grassroots element. These are individuals, delegates from all over the nation, a lot of them involved in local politics. And they're getting together to talk about just that, the changes that they want to see the Republican Party make in their local communities and how they want to bring that forward to a national platform.
Yeah.
They definitely have a lot of work to do, though.
Yeah, where is the base going? Where is the true base going? And where, Mitt Romney as well, along with that base. We'll see what happens here as the days progress this week. But let's talk about the big speakers. Who will make the big splash? Chris Christie gets the primary, the big-time spot at the convention this week. Talk about that.
Yeah, Chris Christie definitely is going to be the top prize speaker, if you will. But we have some speakers that are important to us locally. Our Governor Kasich, of course, is also going to be a big speaker. Our Senator Rob Portman. So for Republicans, they're going to be on the top of the list there, and they're the ones that everyone are really going to be watching.
Is this basically, throwing a bouquet at Rob Portman because he wasn't Mitt Romney's choice as VP? Is this kind of saying, hey, thanks for staying with us. We're going to give you this slot here. What do you think?
I don't think so. Rob Portman definitely has made his own way in the Republican Party. This is not a second best, hey, here's your speech. All along, Portman had told me and many other reporters that he was planning on staying as a senator. Of course, that's what you would expect him to say, but really all along he's been very gracious, and I think a lot of people in the Republican Party certainly look up to him, especially when it comes to fiscal matters.
We keep hearing that Vice President Biden will crash the convention. Tell us about what you're hearing in Washington.
He is, in fact, crashing the convention. Now, Lee, he won't actually be at the Republican convention, but they're going to have sort of a convention of their own on the side there. But the vice president will definitely be in Tampa at the same time that Republicans will be working. There's no word yet whether Republicans are planning anything similar in Charlotte, though.
All right. Well, you talked about Charlotte. Let's touch on that briefly, because after you're in Tampa, you're going to head north. Right up to North Carolina, you're going to cover the Democratic convention for us. So give us kind of the snippet on the Democratic convention. Can't possibly be a repeat of what happened in Denver 4 years ago, can it?
No, I don't think it can. And it's really a tough act to follow for Obama and Democrats. That 08 convention in Denver was extraordinary. And they're going to have to basically work to see if they can pull in any of those voters that might be straying right now. And they're planning to do a pretty good job of it. I can tell you that the Democrats, the way they set up the convention is much different than the Republicans. I've got the list right here, actually, of what they're going to be doing. On the first day, they have this event called Carolina Fest. It's actually not really part of the convention. It's going to be outdoors. There's going to be a Labor Day parade at that event. Then the next 2 days will be more traditional at the Time Warner Cable Arena. So more similar to what you would see for the Republicans. But then that last day, Obama's going to come out in true fashion, like similar to that Invesco field speech you saw in 2008. He will be with Biden at the Bank of America Stadium. So we're really going to see that, and we're going to be able to compare it to what happened in 08 to be able to tell whether or not the Democrats' convention was a success, if it will be.
It'll be fascinating to watch, compare and contrast Tampa up to Charlotte, North Carolina. Our Jacqueline Pola-Castro, our Washington Bureau Chief, has you covered. Jacqueline, thanks so much for joining us on Conklin & Company. We appreciate it. We'll be in touch this week.
You bet. Thanks, Lee.
All right. We're going to be back. Conklin & Company continues. We'll take you out to the movies in Sylvania in just a minute.